We'll be right back. if you're ready, we'll go. We'll maneuver.
Reaching out. We'll be right back. all crave, what we all crave. When the man yells at his son, when he finds the smoking gun. Don't you worry, little one, for we all crave, we all crave. We'll be right back.
drowning in devotion. I'm lost, can't find a new emotion that's ever enough.
Hello and welcome. I'm Laura Cornelius and you're watching the Global Poker League Summer Series live from Las Vegas. Yesterday, we saw Berlin Bear Sorel Mitzi versus Jonathan Jaffe of the San Francisco Rush. And Sorel took that one down for the Bears 2-1. Today's a brand new day. And inside the cube, we have London Royals Igor Kurganov battling it out against Bryn Kenney, manager of the New York Rounders.
Hello, my babies, and welcome to the Global Poker League Summer Series. I am Joe Stapleton. He is Eric Dennis, and we are deep in heat number 5 here from the Summer Series. Eric, what's on tap today?
Yeah, pretty big one. No matter who the players are, when London and New York play, Joe, it is, you know, some headlines are going to be created. But with the players that are in the cube today, it really helps out, helps us out, of course. Igor Kurganov representing the London Royals. And look at this. BK back in the cube. Bryn Kenney, the team manager for the New York Rounders, needing those 9 points and saying, I'm going to collect those 9 points myself. So it'll be a really big match. Both players have played in the cube once before, Igor losing to Fedor Holtz 2-1, and Bryn, I might have just messed that up. Both have lost, actually.
So that's good.
Late breaking news.
Everyone's going to improve. Everyone's going to have a better day today than they had last time.
That's right. Bryn Kenney losing to Anatoly Filatov 2-1 last week, actually just a few days ago in the cube. So right back at it today for both of these players.
You know, we didn't ask him, but do you think Igor faces particular punishment from his team manager if he doesn't do well?
I said it before. Justin Bonomo did say that Liv does, admonish. You know, there's punishment involved.
It doesn't sound like maybe it's that motivating is the thing.
Well, sometimes threats are motivating.
Right, but the thing is, if you like what happens as a result.
Yeah, that's the major problem with some of these players on this team. You're right. Although they're doing well, they're in third place, so hey.
All right, we're going to focus on the other team for now. Let's take a look at the America's Conference standings.
We've talked about the Montreal Nationals ad nauseum, Joe, but they are still leading the way. 130 points. They're in the cube later on this week, actually on Thursday, as Paris plays Montreal in an all-French matchup. And we might just have no French-speaking players in the cube. So we'll
just
have to
so happens that the Frenchest member of the crew is in here. While Eric, yeah, exactly, he has legitimately threatened me before over the French jokes. It's okay, I'm just going to throw a baguette over on the other side of the curtain. He's gone.
Salted butter.
There it goes.
The New York Rounders are in the cube today, Joe, 99 points, 10 points out of third, and that's quite surprising. We've talked about the Rounders being a little bit of an underachiever so far this year. Bryn Kenney mentioned, and he was right in saying Montreal or a team that finishes first wouldn't rather have to play someone else. The issue now for the Rounders, Joe, is that the San Francisco Rush are just 3 points behind, so
right.
Suddenly we have a playoff race, and Bryn Kenney does need some points today.
Yeah, absolutely. So that's the main storyline today, is that the New York Rounders need to accumulate some points to put a little bit of distance and keep that safe third place spot so that they make the playoffs at the end of the season. Let's take a look at the Eurasian Conference. Thank you.
And as we mentioned, the London Royals tied with the Hong Kong Stars, but do have more wins, so that tiebreaker does come into effect at the moment. Both teams have yet to play so far this week, Joe. This heat, Joe. London with 103 points. Still trailing the Moscow Wolverines, who now have a 7-point lead. After today, the Wolverines will have a game in hand. That being said, the London Royals could actually move up to first place with a sweep for Igor Kurganov. They could move up to 112 points, 109 or 106, or they could, stay there and actually drop a spot, as Hong Kong would then have a a match in hand. So, you know, that's interesting to see what happens there. The Aviators, who were struggling for a bit, are suddenly just 2 points back of the second place, so right back in it. And then we do have the Berlin Bears and Rome Emperors. For them, it's not as successful of a story as the San Francisco Rush have been recently. Still a lot of work to do for those bottom two teams.
You know, I got some issues with the GPL.
Oh, I thought you meant issues.
I mean, I have plenty of those, and we could talk all the live long day about that. I feel like it might be shorter just to deal with my one issue with the Eurasian standings. I don't like that there's two teams tied for second. I think there should be two teams tied for third.
All right. Lovable losers.
That's all.
Okay.
I feel like that's generous.
Well, you and I will on air, we'll talk about them being both tied for third, although technically they're tied for second.
They're tied for second. It's fine. One of the players who plays for that team that's tied for second is on the floor right now with Laura Cornelius. That's Igor Kurganov.
He is indeed. Igor Kurganov right here with me for the London Royals. We just looked at the Eurasian standings, so you're tied second and third with the Hong Kong Stars. What do you say to that? You could have been in front, but you lost to Fedor.
Yeah, I mean, everyone is losing to Fedor, so it's not that big a surprise. Otherwise, it's a good start. Like, we're second in points right now. I feel like we have the better team, so I think it's going to be good for us overall.
Today, of course, if you manage to win all three games in the match, then you will go ahead to first place. Is that pressure on your shoulders?
I'm happy with 2-1, 3-0. Either works.
Okay. And what about your opponent, Mr. Bryn Kenney, manager of the New York Rounders?
Well, he definitely can play, and he also wants a win. Like, we'll see. One of us will be happy.
How are you going to adapt your strategy to play someone like BK?
We'll see. I actually haven't played much heads up with him, except like some sit and goes maybe. So I don't know exactly what to expect, but he's definitely a tricky guy. So. Could be interesting.
I think it will. He will be entering the cube very shortly. We'll be interviewing Bryn Kenney after this as well. Back to you guys at the desk.
Is it just me or does Igor Kurganov look like the guy in the bar that does everything to avoid the fight? And he's just like, listen, you're not going to want to do that. Let's just all have a drink. And then he just beats up a bunch of people, like just by sort of moving his hand in various directions when he has to.
Sort of like Patrick Swayze. In Roadhouse, but different?
Well, Patrick Swayze in Roadhouse, I feel like, really wanted to rip someone's throat
true,
out.
That's true, yeah.
As opposed to Igor, who would just sort of go like, he'll be like, look, I warned you, and then touch
boom,
someone, and they just drop out like that.
That would be cool.
I think that Igor's definitely got that in him. Let's take a look at Igor's stats so far in the GPL.
Yeah, his best world rank was number 7, which was a few years ago, Joe, October of 2013. He's played 6 matches, which is quite a bit, tied for 10th in the league, 19th in points with 22, and he's been split there. Olivia's split him between 6 max and heads up, 10 points and 6 max, 12 points and heads up, so in either situation, he's been quite successful.
Pretty good, considering he's only got 1 win.
That's right, 1 win. The 6 max competitions, he's managed to rack up points, but not wins, so yeah, you're right. Only 1 win, tied for 48th, and his total points percentage at 37th in the league at 44%. That loss to Fedor Holtz actually put him under the 50% mark. So that's where he stands right now. Very, very solid stats. You know, not in the top tier, but very close to it. So really good start to the season for the Kurganator. How terrible is that?
The Kurganator,
the
absolutely.
Kurganator. I like it.
Can you do me a favor? Where on here does it say what his current GPI rank is?
Right here.
Ah, there it is, and big, probably the biggest number on the entire page. Thank you. I just, you know, that would have required for me to read all the way down.
Right. Yeah, and I do all this research for Joe, and he doesn't read it.
No.
As you can tell by today, there's not much. There's stuff missing.
We got some blank pages here, guys.
Blank stuff.
There's
blank
nothing stuff there. Yeah. That's okay. I don't read it anyway. It's fine.
Mine is now full because I didn't.
Because you did your research, and you're a hard worker, and, you know, I'm me.
It's all right.
Hey,
it's
let's
all right.
take a look at Bryn Kenney's stats.
Speaking of hard work. Number 2
Bryn
in the world.
Bryn Kenney, handsome for a man. Look at him.
Love Bryn Kenney. Love me some BK. He's only played 3 times, Joe, but he's been quite spectacular, you know, minus that defeat to Anatoly Filatov, but still 36th in the league. He's half through all those players, and he's only played 3 times, so 15 points in 3 games. That's in 3 matches, sorry. That's 5 points per match played. That's, you know, quite reasonable. He's not played in 6 max, all in heads-up competition, those 15 points. tied for 31st, one win as well, just like Igor, except his win was out of three matches played. And that's a points percentage, quite respectable at 55.6%, currently 22nd in the league, just like Igor did drop a few points by losing to Anatoly Filatov last week in the Cube. So, yeah, both players quite respectable starts to the season. It's just that Bryn hasn't played as much, but I do feel that Bryn's going to play a lot more in the second half because this team does need the points, as we mentioned, our friend John Newcomb mentioning that a lot more pressure on Bryn Kenney today than on Igor Kurganov. Bryn needs to get some breathing room for his team because right now the rush are coming. I didn't do that on purpose.
Eric Danis loves the game of poker, and he loves Bryn Kenney, who is down on the floor with Laura Cornelius.
Thank you, Joe and Eric. Bryn Kenney for the New York Rounders. They were talking about the pressure. You guys started so well. You were top of the league for quite a while, and then you're suddenly in fourth. You're in the danger zone kind of thing.
Yeah, well, we're just letting other people think that they have a chance. So we're just hanging out low, and we'll see what happens.
And that last match you played, talk us through that with Anatoly, because it was fun to watch.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like I completely crushed Anatoly and easily could have beaten him 3-0. I beat him in pretty much every single pot that wasn't all in and then lost way more all in pots. So, I mean, that's just poker. Sometimes you lose all ins and nothing you could do.
Playing today, Igor Kurganov, he mentioned you've maybe dabbled a little bit, but not so much heads up together before. How are you changing your strategy from someone like Anatoly to Igor?
Well, I guess we'll have to find out, right?
I guess. He stood there, so that's, yeah! I guess, why he doesn't want to say. And I like, you've come dressed like you're going to the beach today.
For
we
sure.
know it's hot in there.
Dealing with the heat. It's like you're
it.
In the sun.
All right, well, this game is about to get underway. Back to you guys before game one in the Cube.
It is very, very warm here at the Hacienda Park and Ride. We have just almost, I mean, it's...
I like it.
The sun's just pouring right through.
Yeah.
Anyway, hey, I want to remind everybody that we are, we're lonely. Not just in our personal lives, but here at the desk on the GPL. We'd like you to get in touch. Holler at us, twitch.tv/GPL. Tweet at us using the hashtag GPL. It would be nice to read some tweets that actually belong to the Global Poker League and aren't just mistakes.
Right.
From other people who like messed up like Jim Pam Laundry and stuff like that. Yeah. Want to read some of these that have come in here. Over 9,000 BPM says, we heart Bryn Kenney. Let's see. Bob Sapp, who says, this smug B word. Yikes. Oli Blaha. Oh, that's Oliver Blaha. I get it. Or Blaha. He hates sleeves also. Pardukes loves the outfit. You guys, honestly, you've not been in here. What's that movie, Cool Hand Luke?
Yeah.
Where they got to go in the sweat box?
Yeah.
That's this.
This is more, yeah.
This is possibly worse than that. Someone's going to eat a lot of hard-boiled eggs today. Eric.
What about Girth Turkish? OMG, enough talking. Let's get on with it.
Okay. Girth Turkish, you said it best. Let's get down to the cube.
Players, please enter the cube.
So, you know, me and the woman that do the voice dated briefly.
Oh.
Yeah.
Players, is it up? Please enter the queue.
Oh, they're being asked a second time. She's very polite.
No, well, the thing is, she's not.
Oh.
I know that bitch voice anywhere.
Oh, damn. Now, is it because you found out recently
Joe Stapleton, please enter the bed. I said I'd be there when I'm ready.
Did you date her because you found out that I used to be the Ticketmaster voice? Is that
Yeah, it's me trying to get close to you, buddy boy.
I like it.
Hand number one, underway. 50,000 in chips for each of these two jokers. Blinds 2 and 400, and I'm going to shut up.
In that hand?
Yep.
Cool. I like it. Min-raise for speed, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, I'm fine with that.
And like half-potting and stuff.
Oh, this could be a delicious hand, Joe.
Yum!
Yeah, it's got all the good buttons at least. Pot, third pot, half pot. Mm. It needs three-quarter
pot,
Doesn't have
the
though.
Big ones. Yeah, it's just like it wants you to bet small
So instead
time.
Of betting three-quarters, I'll just have to bet pot. First
year. I'm a pretty lazy player myself. The only difference, I'm not a winning player.
No matter what you do. It really doesn't matter what you do.
I think we're going to have to go over pot now.
Wait, you bet 400.
No, oh, that was a mistake. Oops.
I called the 400.
Fuck. Igor calls, and he is right.
Ooh. No.
Bryn, I would suggest if you're going to bluff, bet a little bigger.
No.
misclick.
Tiny value bet. Who knows?
I will say it's very easy. Now, my limited experience in there, that you can set out a gigantic bet and then very easily still just hit call.
Like
a little bit mean.
not call, sorry, but whatever the min bet is.
Maybe. I'm not a hero call kind of guy, though.
You got the 9 blocker, too. That's a problem.
Yeah.
You crit me, says Igor has the team jersey. The jerseys have power. Still waiting for those Rounders jerseys to come in. This the problem is the...
Who needs a jersey with that?
Give it to me.
That display of chest hair.
The Tropicana park and ride is difficult to find. It's not. There's not even an address. That's the problem.
There isn't.
Good thing is that you like actually just bet and you don't have... Because people started doing the crane.
Yeah.
That's super annoying. I hate the crane.
Mike McDonald.
The crane is now very popular.
I think Mike stopped doing the crane once he realized that it causes a major annoyance for dealers.
Yeah, it's the new of like how many chips you got every single hand. Now it's just the crane motion.
Yeah. Okay, so this left button I do not want to press.
Yeah, just type in the number first, I think. God, one card is so good, the other one's not so good.
Same for me. The 7 of diamonds.
Such a good card.
The hand should just auto come up, though, when you... instead of having to press this I button, yeah, you've min-raised.
That's all right.
You should have to like press the I button to close your hand, so it always shows you.
So it's always shown, yeah. Small.
Players are split on that, that's why we've included that button, but a lot of players like that hand hidden. As you mentioned, you yourself had that hand hidden for the most part.
Yeah, for some reason I was just inclined to keep them cards down. I mean, I do like it when the players go interact with each other at their terminals, so.
Hopefully not in... And all in
pot. Also, Marc-Andre has fantastic vision, so he could have seen your cards.
He pretended like he made a misclick, but it was, he actually had a straight. It was so good.
He like all in it and like played it off well.
He like min-raised on the turn instead of like, oh shit, because we were also talking about before how like the race is on the left and this. Such a dig, it was so good though. Really well done.
Wow, he sharked you hard there.
Yeah. And I had the perfect hand for it. I had like a flush draw and a gut shot blocking straight, so I fucking was going for it. Oh, I forgot. I should learn to have better language, I was told.
He speaks like 5 languages and he knows how to say shit in all of them.
Ooh. Wow.
It's a reminder from team manager Olivia Boré. Do not swear in the cube unless you're Olivia Boré, and then you can do it. Boré, I'm sorry, Joe. I'm sorry. Stop looking at me that way.
I just don't know what's so hard about that.
I don't know. I like the double E.
Raspberry Boré. It makes sense because Igor looks like Prince Raspberry Boré.
Sean Swag saying that you can't even get in the casino with that tank top. Bryn, Bryn Kenney can get into any casino with... wearing basically nothing.
Because he's got 2 tickets to the gun show and they get him in anywhere.
I haven't, slow rolling it's got to be pretty good.
Like doing this, but actually just calling.
Like going like this, like but with your hands and just like calling with the nuts.
I like that. Okay, we have a new thing we have to try.
Yeah, only in like real big pot though.
Yeah. Gotta hurt.
Hey, you know what I did last night? Top Golf.
Yeah.
Really fun.
Talk to me. Yeah.
Great
I want to
spot.
Do that.
It's like, it's kind of like bowling. Like, it's like a club. So you got your own little table and cocktail service, but then you got your own little bay. You get to hit golf balls.
Yeah, it's great.
Super fun. The only problem is you get sweaty. Like, I didn't end up hitting very many balls.
Right. I'm not sure.
Because you get that. Sweaty balls.
You don't want to have sweaty balls.
So many 3-bets, BK.
3-bet world.
And Bryn flops pretty good.
How much is that, quarter or third?
What did yes, quarter? Ed Kilworth. Sorry, I don't know how to say Warburton.
Little cheese on top.
Apparently it's Wubbardon. Yeah, apparently you're supposed to say Wubbardon.
Oh, it's Worcestershire.
That's a third turn, right?
Yeah.
Oh!
What were you looking for? How'd you point
this
screen?
Damn you, River! This could have been a great, great fun. Damn you, River.
Damn you, River. Sbok 30 says, too early, guys.
Ooh.
Huberius says, what a beauty. Boss says, Bryn looks a bit like Trevor from Grand Theft Auto 5. And John Paul says, Bryn looks like a reincarnated mob boss Al Capone.
He said Brian. He wrote Brian looks like it.
Brian. Oh, well, yeah. He just had an extra A in there.
Hey.
Bryn. Igor said he didn't like to get hero-y, but he is thinking about it now. Tree Trunk says Bryn's tank top is triggering me.
I don't have to call.
Just lock yourself in your room. We can't have another incident, my friend.
PK. You got it.
Ship it.
No, I called. Sheet. Jack 10 off. I didn't think of three, but then.
Jack 10 off.
Damn.
Nice hand.
Three-bit shit.
Three-bit that shit.
Whoa!
Whoa! My God, that's amazing.
It's like straddling, pretty much.
Well, Bryn could very well give this just his chips back here. I can't talk. Or he could river a straight flush. Or not. Futile habit. Is it legal for Bryn to use his sex appeal to tilt his opponent? Damn right it is.
No, Bryn, no, he's too sexy. No, 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 don't do it, Bryn. Oh, he's too sexy. Top pair for Mr. Sexy.
Min-raise.
Yep.
Bottom pair for Mr. Sexy.
Other Mr. Sexy. I'm too sexy for this flop.
You got it.
Nice.
Oh, baby, you.
What do you got?
Lines up, 400, 800.
Joe, I ran into our good friend George Danzer.
Hold me closer, George Danzer.
He said we're doing a fantastic job and says he watches every single one of our broadcasts. So thank you, George. And also apologizes to the audience for not being able to be here the two times he was supposed to. The first time he won a bracelet. The second time he noted the fact that I predicted he would cancel on us because he would make another final table. And he did. And boy, that man won a bracelet 2 days ago. His fourth career bracelet matches Max Piscatori. Most bracelets by Europeans.
Oh, what a feeling when your Danzer on the ceiling.
I like that man. Was wearing a beautiful suit yesterday at his bracelet ceremony.
Been working on my George Danzer impression, but I'm not ready to wheel it out just yet.
You like to raise.
If you've never met George Danzer, you're missing out on life. He's just a fantastic person to be around.
Sure.
Oh, come on, Joe.
No, I like George Danzer. He's a fun guy.
He's never looked upset in his life.
I've not.
He doesn't have a negative thought in his brain.
I've not spent much time with George Danzer outside of the commentary booth. But he is a regular on EPT Live.
Yeah.
Nice little turn card here that sees Bryn pick up a pair, Igor pick up a straight draw to go with his pair.
You typed that one in, huh?
Because they don't have the three quarters for me.
Why? Why would I have a straight draw? The board pairs, you pair. I mean, come on. I'm sick of this.
If that cube wasn't locked, I would let you go in there and tell him.
Do I have a missed draw or do I have a hand?
It's time you talk to your head something. Definitely bet the jack, definitely bet the queen.
I Ooh, Igor called.
Darn.
Give me the money.
No.
Gives a big one to Bryn. Igor now with a sub 20 big blind stack.
Get it.
Third time today that Igor makes a hero call, and twice it's not worked out.
20 BB limping time.
All right.
Nobody connects with this flop. Hello, Sir Banker Willie.
Okay, for the second match. We'll
hello, Timmy player. Top Deck.
Timmy Top Deck.
Ed Kilworth says, I'd like to see Igor with a couple of man croissants.
All right.
You know who's into that? French production team. All about it.
They do like themselves some male French croissants.
I want to see him with a man pain au chocolat.
I digested a pain au chocolat this morning.
I know, Alex gave me one and I forgot to take it.
That's great.
Pain suisse? A man pain suisse?
I don't even know what that is. I stopped at pain au chocolat because it's bread with chocolate.
You're a disgrace.
No, I'm good.
Blinds 501,000.
We're at 501K, so you got
thanks, Bryn. I just said that. Igor, 11 big blinds. He's all in with a suited king. Bryn has a hand that's probably right on the line. He calls. Two clubs on the flop.
Show us. Two chances.
Two chances.
80% chance to chop.
Two pair.
And this is not a chop, and not everybody loves it. Just Igor Kurganov, who doubles up to 22 big blinds.
More work for Bryn.
Oh, there's Georgie Danzer in the chat.
What are you doing? Limp? No, you're raised. Man.
What a man.
No.
Igor all in again. Bryn's got a fold.
Got through the slow roll.
George did mention that he'll try his best to either be in the booth or in a cube this summer, but he's probably going to win everything, so it's not going to happen.
How about that crazy haircut, huh? That George Danzer, does he still have that?
It's pretty cool.
It's the only the only haircut in the world to me that looks painful. Like, he looks like he just got out of a mental hospital.
Give me the mic.
Give it to you.
Joe Braz, what's up, buddy? Thanks for being here. I appreciate y'all, my babies. Well, you got a Fitbit there? Is that what you got, buddy?
Yeah, man. I've had it for a few years. That's how I lost all the weight.
Oh, because you...
Thank you, Fitbit.
That's nice that you can keep track of it as you go.
Yeah.
Probably gets addictive after a while, right?
Like, yeah, it becomes a video
calories
game.
And stuff, yeah. Do, 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 do. That explains why I saw you jumping on turtles outside.
There were dead turtles.
Did you go running this morning?
I did.
6 o'clock in the morning?
It was a bit later at 7 because we were missing a player.
Oh, you were up freaking out trying to find who was going to play today?
Yeah.
You actually think you could accomplish something at 7 o'clock in the morning?
It actually worked.
Really?
Yeah.
You got a response.
From BKO.
From Bryn.
Yeah.
Not from Olivia Bore.
No, she was fine. We already knew Igor was playing. Yeah, I assume Bryn was just had not gone to bed. And of course, then our girl, Laura Cornelius, took over and made sure Bryn would get here because that's how she rolls. Joe, in my run this morning, I did pull a little left hammy, so if you can help me with a massage, I would appreciate it.
I'll do it right now, homie.
Thanks, buddy.
Get in there. Ooh, that's tight.
I know it's deep.
That is tight.
Thanks, man. By the way, Igor could really take over. We could be even in chips after this one.
That's a dumb raise, Igor.
Oh,
you're losing the ace
raise.
King. No, I'm just kidding.
Oh, sorry.
He's got a raise.
I should have let you finish. I didn't know if you were joking.
Generally,
I knew you were
joking. Generally, if I say someone's doing something dumb, I'm joking.
True.
I gave you a discount. I don't know if they accepted it. I made it $99.99.
I don't know if I'm going to accept that discount.
I think they just went 10K.
Everybody
want chip back.
Everybody knows what $99.99 really means, Igor. You're not fooling anybody.
God, he got away from that. Well done.
Well, it's bottom pair, right?
It's true. But he had a straight.
Good fold
for what? You.
He had a straight. They both had straights.
Bryn had a straight.
Yes.
Good fold.
Yeah.
I thought he just had a pair.
Either of a king or an eight.
I'm not really good at reading the board or bet sizing.
To be fair, we were having our hamstring discussion during, okay. And I just noticed at the bottom it said what they had.
Oh, man, I could just read that, huh?
That's the only reason I knew what they had.
That's funny. I don't really pay attention. I'm not mathematically inclined.
What's that supposed to mean?
You're not reader.
Exactly. I don't think.
Exactly.
I don't know what range merging is. I don't believe in M.
Snaps it.
What was that? Oof. What the fuck was
Dangerous
that?
Dangerous card. Let's see. What do you got here? You got about pot?
Yeah.
It's good for pot.
Pot is all in.
Lol, not good at understanding jokes, says Kaiken 17.
Why would he write that?
Bran is tanking. Oh no, Bryn's the one who's jammed.
Yeah, this is why you love the New York Rounders and Bryn Kenney. They are just merciless. Igor's probably going to fold this, and it's the best hand. Oh god, he calls.
Ooh, we're back.
Good call.
Wowee.
I just called every time.
Wow.
Big pot.
He has called every time, by the way. He is right.
Obviously.
Hero call count. He is 1 for 3. But that was a big one.
Wow, what a comeback. Commentating myself for myself.
AJ says Bryn is a beast. Wow.
Snap call.
Muffin Fred says, did Bryn lose? Yes, he lost the hand, not the game. He's still got 30 big blinds and he's raising.
Pot, boy.
So much bluff.
Joe, I don't...
Big chip.
I don't know this for a fact, but 31 hands could be the longest Bryn Kenney game in history.
And it takes away from the ace highs.
You can see why.
Every single time.
Yeah, he's swearing again. It's a $5 penalty. These players are being punished.
John Paul says they say people who swear a lot are highly intelligent.
Okay. Take it.
One sounds like bullshit to me.
I used to swear a lot, and now I don't swear.
Really?
Does that mean I'm dumb? Or? Yeah, it's part of my cleansing.
Oh, really?
To be honest, in French Canada, we do have...
You guys cuss a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've eliminated that, yeah.
On the button, that's good.
I basically become a priest. I mean, to be fair, in the bedroom as well, right? So, yeah, I'm good.
Yeah, I think we got to pursue this Wellman thing for you.
You know, the boss got excited by that proposal yesterday. He's threatening to do a Twitch clip, putting it out there.
I don't like setting people up, though, because there's always one person who's offended, or both. They're like, really? Right. Really? That's what you think of me? That person? Really?
Hey! Now I'm offended that you think that Jess might be offended by me.
You could also be offended.
No, I don't get offended
cool
by
on,
anything.
On TV.
No, I don't get offended by anything.
Actually, I'd like to see what you have there.
Jessica, just to let you know, I am, never available, because I'm counting stats. But so is she, yeah, so.
They could put up like a screen here, actually, for a game, so we can
just
make fun of each other as well.
ST Math Maestro says occasional swearing is healthy to let out pent-up anger, good release without physically harming something or someone. I can only assume that ST Math Maestro has both degrees in sociology and psychology.
Does this person know about the Serenity Now method?
Serenity
works
Now.
Every time.
Serenity Now. I learned that from my friend Lloyd Braun.
He's the best.
All in. If you 3-bet, I might just go all in.
That's why I just went all in.
Stacks evening out. 31 bigs, 30 bigs. Game one.
My Amber's 4-5 suited.
Who will draw first blood?
Either, so.
Highly caffeinated, in a word, no.
Pot. You like the pot.
Bryn betting big with top pair. It's the best hand and the best draw.
Igor noticing that Bryn likes the pot.
Aha! He is a fan of the pot.
Betting the pot.
Hmm.
making a big fold.
Igor folds the 6-high flush. It's going to put Bryn out in front by a small margin.
What else did I have?
These guys are battling.
Yes, they are. We are up to 800, 1600, by the way.
Folded a small flush.
If you folks haven't seen the Bryn Kenney Pascal LeFrancois match from earlier this year, you must. It is just a fantastic match where Bryn just went out, goes out swinging, and LeFrancois takes no bullcrap from Bryn and just defends and defends. And it's a quite spectacular match. Yeah. It lasted about 10 seconds, so.
Okay.
No.
Do you know what I did? Oh, you do.
No.
Cool. Now Igor gets the lead back.
Whew. Okay, we're getting back.
Igor flops top pair and bets it. Muffin Fred says Igor could have won,
but he didn't.
Ace.
But now he's got a big lead.
So we play on, players.
Good.
Muffin Fred.
Bryn's down to 65. Excuse me, 16 big blinds. 65 is his hand, which he manages to steal.
7x. I wish that happened in the WSOP tournament. What do we got? 8-16. You have no chips. It's good. Whoa.
Bryn is all in. Igor's got an ace.
Uh-oh. What do we got? Can I see? One card? Can I turn over somehow just one card?
Ooh.
Ooh.
Wait, I'm going to do this.
That just made me dizzy. What are they doing?
It's like they're
do-si-doing out there.
Another one comes back. I only have to see throw away the three of diamonds.
See if you get a new card.
Come on.
Igor hoping this was a draw.
Shit.
It came back as the three of diamonds.
Three tries. Okay, still three of diamonds. Then I fold.
No draw games.
It's the only way to win there, I think.
Muffin Fred says Bryn is done. I don't know, Meng.
It's hard to kill him. If he makes a wrong move here, he could be.
Bitmog is angry. He does not like them switching terminals.
Oh.
Why can they do that? You know why? Because it's fun.
And they're locked in a cube and no one else is in there, so nothing much we can do about it.
We're just trying to have some fun here, my babies.
For me.
It's good.
Back home.
Wow, Bryn, calling pretty light.
Check.
Bro.
I guess it's not. Oh, we got some Mustafa Cannon happening out there. Bro. Bro.
Bro.
Bro.
Let's see what you got.
All in.
No.
No. Yeah, I had a pretty good start.
Bryn busts.
Nice hand.
Got caught with the hand in the cookie jar.
Blinds were getting high. He had to make some moves. I tell you what, Eric Dennis, I love the game of poker, and I love Bryn Kenney, but he is now down 3 points to none here after one game of this match in heat number 5.
Yeah. First of all, I'm wearing a t-shirt.
It's okay.
And
I know you feel self-conscious, but like, what are we doing here? I mean, we're...
It's a little warm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We just got to make sure that we don't pass out.
Speaking of warm, it got really hot and intense in that queue between
these
two players. Yeah.
You know, I noticed that a lot of folks out there, Daniel Negreanu being one of them, preaches the small ball poker.
Yes, they
that was big ball poker.
Yeah. Good job, sir.
I didn't really do anything except change small to big.
You probably did that also like 8 years ago when Daniel wrote the book on small ball.
Big
poker.
Ball poker Big happening balls. In there between Bryn and Igor Kurganov. A pretty exciting match. We saw Igor with three hero calls, wrong twice, but the one that mattered the most, he was right and managed to double up. And that was really, I think, the turning point of the match.
Yeah, it's also interesting that Bryn has used his strategy in every one of his heads-up matches this year, but it seems like the opponent, instead of wanting to then play small ball, just says, all right, let's do
let's
this.
Let's play big ball.
LeFrancois Filatov last week, and now Kurganov is like, yeah, let's play. So it's fun for us because we'll probably be out of here in about 7 minutes, although this one lasted way longer than I anticipated. So just some fun poker here. I guess when all the fun is done, though, that means that London now moves up to second in their conference, or at least is alone in second. And the Rounders just still 3 points ahead of San Fran. They need some points here.
I mean, the thing about small versus big ball, right, is you can force someone to play big ball. You can't force them to play small ball.
Right, that's true.
The bets only go one way.
Well, you know that Jonathan Little book? Why weren't you in there?
You know, I got
just quips.
I got a suggestion maybe for Hold'em X.
Okay.
What if you can reduce a bet instead of raising?
I like it.
Right? Nobody's ever thought of that before.
Yeah, I raise minus 20.
Yeah, exactly. I unraise this pot. I want to play a smaller ball.
I'm taking some chips back.
You know, also while we're doing it, I just want to pitch one thing here. Cards up Hold'em tournaments.
Yeah.
It's a bluffing game. All right, let's talk to these to the small and the big balls themselves down on the floor with Laura.
I am indeed. 3 points. First game, go to the London Royals. Congratulations, first of all.
Thank you.
Three hero calls, but you made the one that mattered.
Well, yeah, this is if you bet pot every time, you have to be right one out of three times so that it pays off. I think he bet a little bit less than pot, so I'm fine. It's just like small like correctness, you know? Still, I wish I folded.
Are you regretting any of your moves?
Never regret anything.
That's the way.
You can regret losing with a king three against my king three.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, that was tough, that one.
That king three all went downhill after that one.
Yeah. Are we going to win the next game, though? That's what's important.
I guess we'll find out, right?
Is it going to be tough getting back into it after losing the first game?
No, when you play poker, you're used to losing. You're used to winning. It's all in the game.
Okay.
EA.
Exactly. So, EA Sports. It's in the game.
How's the cube affecting you? Is it hot?
It is.
You're moving around.
It is actually hotter than I expected it to be, or that I remembered. I guess Vegas got hotter as well. You can get like a mist thing inside, which just constantly rains.
We'll and see we if we can do that well for season inside. Two, maybe.
Mist would be
Might
nice.
Be a little ambitious for right now. But London Royals have 3 points so far. We're going to see if they can take down this match and stay in first place in the Eurasian Conference. New York, you need those points, though. They will be trying to get back in the next game. Back to you.
Can't get enough of the GPL? Head over to globalpokerleague.com for the most complete and up-to-date standings, schedule, stats, and information on your favorite team, as well as full-length match replays, highlights, and epic hands from all of our matches, and much, much more.
A lot of chat on Twitch right now about Igor's suggestion to add some mist to the cube. I will have you know, that sounds highly dangerous as far as there's 40,000 watts of electricity flowing through that cube. I don't think we want to mix water with that.
Joe, just quickly here. Bryn Kenney said something that's quite remarkable. He said that we're used to winning, used to losing. And I just got a private message from the gold member, Fedor Holtz. He said, what's losing?
Fedor Holtz is not used to losing. Yeah, he's going to have to get readjusted to that.
Gold member. Do you like that I call him gold member now?
Nope. I think I just liked golden dick. I thought that was fine.
All right.
Golden Richard. How about that?
Golden Richard.
Golden Richard.
Who knew that he was Fedor Richard Holtz?
That won't get us kicked off of Poker Central saying Golden Richard. I'm almost positive.
Welcome on Poker Central.
That's right. Hi, everyone. We're just down in the middle of the day. No big deal. Saying Golden Richard as many times as we can. So we are gearing up for game number two here. We already know that the score is 3-0 in favor of the London Royals. And we know that New York really needs some points so that they can solidify their playoff spot.
Yeah, right now it's the team that was in, it looked like a four-team race where the race was done. San Fran has really done well, scoring 12 points in a 24-hour span, thanks to 9 from Faraz Jaka, and suddenly they're only 3 points back, and they played that game. So they've played 29. New York players their 29th game now. Should New York be shut out, then that means that they end Heat 5 3 points ahead, and they could leave the summer series actually out of a playoff spot, and that would be a major upset.
Ruh-roh.
Yeah.
You know, I heard Laura ask Bryn if he had any regrets, and Bryn was like, nah, no regrets, never. Mm-mm. I do have one regret today.
Oh.
Eating that sandwich that I left out all night. I'm really feeling it right now.
Was there mayo on there?
Oh, yeah.
Cheese?
Yep.
Oh, God.
Both.
Yeah.
And there was like a good amount of vinegar on it, too. So that was just smashing home the vinegar and the mayo.
That does wonders to the stomach.
It's really weird. I like food that's left out. I don't like refrigerated food.
Right. Because I saw wings left out, and someone in the house put it in the fridge thinking they were doing a good thing, and you did not like that.
It's not that I didn't like it.
Because chicken left out, probably not.
Well,
like,
the
safe.
Thing is, the person that did that put them in the fridge first, which I appreciated.
Right.
Even though I prefer them room temperature, but then when I found them again, they were in the garbage.
Oh.
Yeah, which, to be fair, I did come home rather intoxicated and have some of them, so maybe I threw them away myself.
The good news is... I mean, you've got a lot of power in that house because that person is now back.
Gone.
Home. Yeah.
Gone.
Boom. Get out of here. We don't care who you know.
Let's not get political here. It's fine. I was going to make myself a good little Brexit joke, but we're just going to skip that and do what we came here to do, which is to play some poker to the power of three. Let's start game number two now down in the cube.
Yeah, it's going to take a while for sure.
Yes. Transpired. Think of the left out food as strengthening your immune system. Raffle. That's part of the reason I do it.
That's true, actually.
Because I'm like a cast iron stomach, you know what I mean? It's hard.
No, I got it. I have a friend that's like that. That's pretty crazy that I'll eat something that's been expired for 3 weeks and no problems.
Out the gate. Let's go.
Out the gate is right. Igor, a top pair. Bryn with a cute little draw.
Okay, let's see.
Cute little double gutter.
Pots 15.
No, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, that's a double gutter. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That is a double gutter.
Dude, you got like 5, 7, don't you?
Bryn is all in.
Or 6, 3 off.
And gets the best hand to fold.
Hey, Decrypt Me says that you and I are a perfect match. Or something else. Blend.
It did have a 3.
I like feudal habits. Suggestion coming soon to ESPN8, The Ocho.
We would be great on The Ocho.
It's really sad that that's the absolute best joke in that entire movie, by the way.
It is.
The Ocho.
It is.
The movie's not very good.
But it's got Stiller's wife, and she's very, very charming.
Look, all the pieces are there. You got Vince Vaughn. You got Ben Stiller. You got Jason Bateman.
It's true. Oh, my God. I forgot about him.
You raised those.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The guy with Bateman, I don't know his name, but he was fantastic.
I don't remember. I only saw the movie once.
We've got the Apple guy, Justin.
Good job, Anthony Charter, catching me on pause on, I don't even know what day this is.
That's when I had my suit. Yeah, what am I doing? What are you doing?
One.
Thank you, Charter.
I look a good,
wow,
unflattering photo.
Anthony Charter runs social media for the Montreal Nationals.
Hey, bonjour, bonne chance, merci beaucoup.
Chips bag.
And he's an Ottawa Senators fan. That joke registered to all Canadians, and that's about it. 4 people in Dallas.
I need to bring... Wow, kings, man.
Igor gets a walk with a couple of man queens.
Kappa.
Full big hand.
Futile habit, thank you. He's really pushing the fact we should be on ESPN 8, The Ocho.
No.
I have nothing.
I read a great Brexit joke today.
You suck out.
An Englishman, a Scotsman, and an Irishman walk into a bar. The Englishman wanted to go, so they all had to leave.
Ah!
Here's one for you. Not my joke, though. Not my joke. Just so we're clear.
That pot.
A fool. Gotta try the different car coming back thing.
Maybe it might come back different one.
Still not.
No straight now.
Oh, man.
It's like Hold'em X, you know, where you can change. Have you played it?
No.
So it's really good. It's actually really good.
And you can change your cards.
You can change your cards, you can change flop, you can like... like there's extra cards which you can use sometimes, but you can only use it once.
Is he not supposed to be saying this stuff about Hold'em X?
No, it's just incredible that you talked about it a minute ago and then...
Oh, it's true. Boom, he's in. Maybe he heard me though. Was it during, while they were in the cube or out?
You get called and then be like, wait, I need one more.
I think you have to decide before.
Before you
first use the special card and then you use the bet size.
But it's really good. So now they know you have three cards.
Yeah.
And you can use it as like sick bluff too, because it's like, yeah, I'm bluffing, I need three.
Oh wait, no, I got it.
Yeah, it's definitely fun.
I mean, is it all nuis? Why are you disappointed? Joe said the Brexit joke, so you should be really happy.
Well, you need the bet.
Alineas.
Alineas?
I don't know.
The heart.
Okay.
Whatever. That's a straight for Bryn, and he's going to win this pot. Blinds 3 and 600, hand number 14.
Should have bet pot so you don't see my cards.
Wiener saying, Bryn is a beast, and he's correct. I mean, Bryn just smashes you over the head at every single decision.
No bet.
Split it up.
Yep.
Quing for Bryn. I think Igor is probably going to take a flop with 10 deuce suited.
Fire, fire.
No, he folded. All right. That's what I would have done. That's why I expected him to do different.
Oh, I don't
know. Joe, you know what Jessica Wellman and I have in common other than long walks on the beach or liking those?
And pina coladas and getting caught in the rain?
We like a good stat, right?
Mm-hmm.
Here's a fun stat. Top 10 finishes for Igor Kurganov this year, 9. Tournaments played, 9.
Finally, I can call.
What?
Hold on. Let's look at this aces.
How's that?
Andre Akari's. Hold on. It gets better with Bryn Kenney.
Dry board.
Half pot. Big hand. 3-quarter pot.
$5,000 is 3/4. $6,000. Didn't work.
He went for $11,000 instead.
All in, baby.
You know why I like hearts?
God, that's a good all in.
Because they're full of blood.
You only have 20,000 chips.
That's all you're going to get, guys. Sorry.
You call, you lose. You fold, you lose.
Back before from 20,000.
He knows Igor loves a good hero call.
But is he bluffing? That's the question.
Is he bluffing?
Are these cards connected with that board or not? They are. They are. They are.
Igor calls and loses.
Yeesh.
Game 2 is over.
What a sweep. Can't sweep BK.
And fast game 2. Nice. Whoa.
Uh-oh. It's fine. Let me help you with that.
Hey guys.
Come here. This is what we do every morning. I help help him tie his tie.
Thank you. Hey,
go.
Whoa.
How are you looking? How are you feeling? There we go. Well done. All right, so that's it. Tied 1-1. Royals won, 3 points.
Yes.
Rounders won, 3 points.
Yep.
Next matchup, what Laura likes to call the decider.
Yep. Still called the rubber match.
Still a lot of big pots being played.
Yeah.
And I just got that. Sponsored by Trojan, the rubber match. Yeah, so we saw a more hero college Yeah. From Igor Kurganov, and this time he's now 1-for-4, and this time it cost him dearly.
Yeah, a weird one, right? And you do want a hero. That's the issue with playing Bryn Kenney. He just slams every pot, and you don't know what the hell's going on. It's fun to see a guy like Igor Kurganov not having a single clue what's happening. Makes us feel good. No, we're not even. What am I saying?
No, it makes me feel good.
It makes Joe feel good, yeah. But it was fun. It was a fun one, and he got caught, unfortunately. And Bryn played that hand fun. I can't wait to watch that hand again since I was making jokes instead.
Do you go back and watch this stuff afterward?
No.
Thank God, man, because you live, sleep, sometimes. Eat, and breathe GPL. This kid bleeds GPL. I don't even know how that's possible, but the letters G and P and L just spill out of his veins.
GPI as well. Henemomp comes out.
Oh, all of it. Yeah. Way to drop them all. How about Hold'em X while we're at it?
Yeah, I don't do that. I don't. No.
You have nothing to do with that.
Nope.
One. Really?
No.
Do you not like it because it's not pure poker? Is that? Do you have like?
Maybe. No. It's literally I don't have time for it, and someone else is involved with it.
Okay. Got it.
And yeah, it doesn't have any stats for me and stuff. So yeah, right now.
Not yet, it doesn't.
Yeah, not yet, but soon. I'm going to be excited.
You're going to be like, Igor Kurganov has played the wizard card in all 14 chances that he's had.
Can you imagine Bryn Kenney with all those extra cards? That'd be fun.
I love the game of poker, and I love Bryn Kenney. You know this already. Let's talk a little bit about what these 3 points mean for the New York Rounders.
Well, it gives them a little breathing room now, 6 points ahead of the rush. They're still 7 points behind Sao Paulo. Let's not forget, when they came to Las Vegas, they were ahead of Sao Paulo, but Sao Paulo has played great in the cube, Felipe Ramos especially. So, 7 points back. They could be up to 4 points back. So it could be really a big turnaround for this team, whom, 24 hours ago were suddenly in trouble. So this is big points on the line for the Aviators. The best they could do is finish where they are right now, second, but be only 1 point back of first. That would be a good step forward and get a little breathing room from the Hong Kong Stars, who play in the cube later on this week. Nananoko back in the cube, so we'll have to see what happens. And of course, with my theory, Nananoko should win 3-0 this moment, so we'll have to see what happens.
That was so much words. In short, who needs these 3 points more?
Oh, the New York Rounders. Yeah, the Rounders.
The Rounders.
Although,
do.
Liv Boré wants to finish first. Boré.
God. Oh
Olivia.
Jeez, come on, Eric.
Olivia!
On. How long? Just call her Liv. Just stick with Liv. It's not like there's any Olivia! Other Livs. All right, let's just see what Igor and Bryn have to say. Get me out of this.
It's hot.
It's very hot, and these two are here down with me. Cube side, we have one apiece now, one for the London Royals and one for the New York Rounders. Talk us through that hand. You fell for it.
What can you do? Gotta keep calling and see what he has. Gotta figure him out for the deciding match. So now we have all of the information. It's very good. No, not that happy. But last hand, still, I get 3-1. One out of four times I was right. I don't think he has aces every time.
Yeah. How
also,
many
it's
more
good
times?
To have the eight there.
How many more times are you going to get aces?
First times, that was a good first time.
Very good.
The 6-3 off, that was the more important one, though. Yeah. Set the stage for the match. First hand, all in bluff, the complete garbage.
2.5x, boom.
Are you going to watch 70. This back and enjoy it?
I already
it?
Know. So,
So this one is the decider.
Yep.
I think the New York Rounders do need the points more. But are they going to get them?
We will find out.
We will find out. Are you going to play any differently? Are you going to keep calling?
Depends if I've got
game.
It.
Why
when,
would I
when I shove all in on the river, I hope I've got it.
So I guess this is going to be another quick deciding match.
Should be.
Okay. Yeah. Right. They're about to play after this quick break.
Can't get enough of the GPL? Head over to globalpokerleague.com for the most complete and up-to-date standings, schedule, stats, and information on your favorite team, as well as full-length match replays, highlights, and epic hands from all of our matches, and much, much more.
Eric, I'm going to go out on a limb here, make a prediction. I think this will be the shortest of the three matches. I think that neither player is going to back down at all. No. I think Bryn's going to keep betting big. I think that Igor is going to keep calling light.
Yeah, I think you're right. And I do think that Igor might actually have the leg up in this one because we're not going to get aces every hand. So Bryn is going to continue to Bryn. And at some point, Igor is going to make the right decision, right? And or not that he doesn't make the right decision. Look at me throwing Igor Kurganov under the bus. But he's 1-for-4 in these moments. So if he's 2-for-5, that's good enough for a win.
Is it?
No.
I mean, it could be good enough for
yeah,
a win.
That's
he's
what
1-for-4
yeah.
right now. All he needs is to be right one more time, and then this match could be over. So right now, the teams are tied 3 points apiece. London Royals, New York Rounders, one game left to play here. Who will it be? I know the players are approaching the cube, and they're ready. So let's get it on. Let's decide this match right now down in the cube.
There it is.
All right, let's get back to the stat because you know this will be over in one hand. So 9 results, 9 top 10s for Igor Kurganov. 14 results, which is ridiculous so far. 12 top 10s for Bryn Kenney. And before people say all they play are super high rollers, look at their hand to mop page. Untrue. So 21 out of 23 results, top 10s. 5 wins combined. That's just ridiculous.
You got to do your homework.
Chip lead
last
gone.
Game, too. Just
like Eric Danis does his homework.
I do my homework.
It feels good to have more in the beginning.
Just firestorm.
Oh, wow.
Fulton 27. I love you, son.
Pappy, no tattoo. I'm definitely afraid of needles. It ain't going to happen. By the way, Joe, someone mentioned earlier that you do not give a crap when I say stuff, and I thought we were buds. Like, I'm really hurt by that.
No,
to finally find out that you don't
no.
give a crap.
No, it's not that I don't give a crap.
Oh.
It's that I don't care about any of this. It's not just the stuff you say.
Oh, that makes me feel way better. Man, the twinkle, how do you fake the twinkle in your eye when you tell a story? That's amazing.
We have our fun. We have our fun. No, it's not that I don't care. It's that sometimes it's just words. It's just this fourth, sixth, top four, and this matches points. And I'm like, oh, my God, make it stop.
Also, to the people at home, Joe does play off that a bit.
Yeah, we're doing
it's
a gag
a
here.
It's
we're
fun.
Doing a gag. I'm the guy that doesn't care. Believe me, nobody cares more than I do about putting out a good product. Nobody.
True. Nobody cares about putting out like Joe Stapleton.
It's time. It was time. It's time. For
sure. Math Maestro back in touch says Hole of X sounds like it could be an enhancement product for poker players.
That's okay.
Sometimes I like to go into the gas station and buy some of those, and I like to ask the gas station attendant what he thinks of them and like really get in depth about it. I'm like, what do you like there? You like the Rhino? You like the Ninja?
Good spot for rings.
They always get weird.
Get it. No raise.
Igor has jumped off to the early lead. Alien just wants to know if I've ever had black pudding while I was in the UK. I tried it. Didn't do much for me. The thought of fried blood, not really.
Yeah, a little blood pudding, yeah.
Oh, chip lead. Such a good card. I had one. Bigger chip lead. Oh, give me the money.
Joe, in my meat eating days, I did not mind a little blood pudding sausage.
First 3-bet. Wow, it works, huh? King deuce.
And of course, your favorite English dish, Joe, French fries.
Love French fries. But yeah, my two favorite English dishes were probably French fries and chicken tikka masala.
See, you know it. Well, curry. The English and their curry.
I find that story highly disturbing, highly caffeinated. I find that to be a breach of CVS ethics.
Check his nice card for me.
Unless it happened in Vegas to where...
Oh, two times with ace high.
I don't mind the smirk because like sometimes you both acknowledge it and they're like, and it kind of breaks the ice a little bit. But the question that followed is a little...
Disturbing.
A little pervasive as far as I'm concerned. Invasive.
pretty bad.
God, Pappy coming in with the business. Potato wedges better than French fries. Line both.
Up. You know, I'm not going to get sucked into another potato wedges versus French fries debates. And all of a sudden, you got a guy coming from the back corner, tater tots.
Tater tots.
Then we got America's poutine. Own. It's just, they're all their own thing, all right? I'm just not getting sucked into this discussion again, okay, Danis?
Well, poutine wins.
Waffle fries, crisp cut, curly fries. They've
those
all,
are good, too.
They've
the
all,
Arby's curly fries.
Yeah, right? I mean, let's just all agree to disagree. It's what makes America great, that you can get fat off a wide variety of fried potatoes.
I heard we should make America great again.
Let's make French fries great again.
Freedom fries.
Freedom fries.
Get it right.
Sweet potato fries, see, I mean...
That's good too, yeah. A little mashed, we didn't talk about mashed potatoes.
You guys want to know where my loyalties lie when it comes to fried potatoes? I love all the things I just said. As far as I'm concerned, you can't beat McDonald's. McDonald's fries, you don't put anything on it, you don't need ketchup or anything, it's just so good. It's that extra sprinkle of narcotics.
Yep, I agree.
That they add.
I agree. our producer believes we're going to get sued. I think we're going to get sponsorship, you and I.
Not bored then, like me.
And you know me as a clean eater. There's nothing I would be more proud of than to represent McDonald's.
When's the last time you had McDonald's fries?
About 4 years ago.
Dude.
I'm not kidding. It's pretty sad. I know.
It's so good.
I understand. Now we're going to get sued because I just said to the world that McDonald's is crap.
I don't think they really argue that case.
It's true. That, yeah.
Like, if I was their marketing person, I'd be like, it's crap, but it's so good, of course you're going to eat it.
I think they should do it that way, but that's not exactly what they're doing, selling salads and crap.
It's so good and so cheap, you can't afford not to have this stuff. Igor flops a set of fours, does not get any action.
No, I can't win. No possible.
Possible, I think he was saying.
Oh.
Not possible.
Yeah.
Math Maestro mentioning that Jim Gaffigan has a great stand-up bit about McDonald's and the fries. You know what's really embarrassing is this one day I thought I had written a really brilliant Hot Pockets bit, and I like pitched it to my friend, and he's like, you can't do Hot Pockets. Like, Jim Gaffigan does like 40 minutes on Hot Pockets, and I was like, ugh!
He's pretty good.
Of course he does. Yeah, he's awesome.
Yeah.
Two pair for Bryn Kenney World. Not his Twitter account, by the way, but it is stellar. Winning. Hey, guys.
Hey.
Che cazzo. All in. I don't beat anything.
Bryn has put
6-7.
Igor all in.
7-9.
And this could
says,
be it.
I don't beat anything after going all in.
If Igor calls, it's over.
The money.
Never call.
Does not call. So that's the first hero
first
fold we've seen.
Joe, you mentioned BK, 14 scores this year, only at the top 13 scores count for GPI Player of the Year. He's now ranked second behind Fader Holtz, shocker. Jason Mercier, third, Dominic Nietzsche, fourth. Members of the
Kenny
GPL.
Is now on is second for Player of the Year?
Correct.
On the GPL?
Yes.
That's a very quiet second place.
Yeah, really? 14 results.
But I'm saying, like, who do we talk about? Like, who's running super hot right now? We talk about Fader Holtz. We talk about Jason Mercier. Yeah. We talk about...
Georgie Danger.
Chance Cornuth,
yeah.
Bryn Kenney World does not come up, and that's unfair, it seems like, if he's...
Yeah, he's got 12 top 10s and 14 scores. My question is, what did he do with those two other scores? How does he not finish top 10? Like, that's quite disappointing. $3.6 million in winnings this year. 10.3 career. 9 wins.
It's BK's world. We're all just living in it. By the way, Burger King. Bryn Kenney.
Oh.
Bring it back to the whole fast food thing.
No, I haven't had Burger King in a long time, obviously. Those fries used to suck.
Both. They still do.
They still do?
They're really bad.
Don't you think someone there should say, hey, our fries suck, but our little sand or chicken thing, that used to be really delicious.
I got one word for you. The Whopper.
Yeah. It's good.
The Whopper is all right.
Bacon double cheeseburger?
We got someone in the booth chiming in hash browns. I do, you know what, the little round potato breakfast hash browns?
Yeah.
I'm for them.
No.
I'll be honest. When it comes to fast food, our producer that's in our ear,
yeah,
that mofo knows his fast
food. Does he know his stuff?
One time I stopped myself. Yes.
If someone said to me that you could either have world peace or you can eat and drink whatever you want with no caloric or health repercussions whatsoever, that would be a ridiculously tough call for me.
It's tough. Can I tell you what a girl asked me recently?
Yeah.
Would I give up
sex? Will you get out of my car?
Yeah. Yeah, before calling the cops, she said, would I give up sex for hummus? And she was upset that I had to think about it.
You lose.
You're saying you had to give up one or the other, hummus?
Yeah, I had to choose. If I had to choose
one. Get out of here. Just stop it.
When you check back, I fold turn.
You gotta understand, as a person that's trying to become a vegan, hummus makes a lot
of... Hummus is a big thing. Like avocado, that's another one.
See, I would give up sex for avocado.
And remember, avocados are good fat, like Kate Upton.
Oh, she's good.
Three times.
Bring it on down to Omeletteville.
You beat five.
It depends on the five. I don't beat 4 or 5.
Okay. No, how you fold five? So sick.
I didn't have five.
You have king high.
Mm-hmm.
Pot. Cool.
Yes, please. Oh, wait, what? Pair of sevens for Igor, not good enough.
Jaffy Poker says, I feel like I need adult supervision to listen to this commentary. Yeah. And he's an adult. Well.
I used to say that my old radio show was neither suitable for adults nor children.
Are we going to have to type, do we know who Charlotte McKinney is?
No.
All right, type her up.
Google.
Love that last name.
Bryn Kenney faced with... No, sorry. Igor faced with yet another chunky bet. And he is way behind. He's not exhibiting much of a poker face, so I think Bryn's not going to mind a call here.
Who's this?
She's sort of an avocado, yeah.
Yeah, Sean Paul, come on.
What's wrong? Come on, what? You don't like?
Wow.
You think it's unfair to call her chubby?
No. What, no. Is she chubby?
Yeah, she's curvy.
Oh,
I guess.
Is that what? Wow, you guys and your crew, that we have different versions of. No, I just thought she was fake-ish, but maybe not.
If the whole McDonald's conversation didn't tell you anything, I don't mind fake.
No. Push time. 14 and a half big blind. Can we put him in the dirt this time?
You know, these matches have gone just as long as some of the other ones. You know, not this, these matches, these games. You know, we're not any earlier or later than we normally are at this point. But this has been really fun. It's gone by very quickly.
Give me the 2,200.
No.
Oh, kicker play.
Wow,
no,
kicker play. Kicker,
don't play. Saw two low cards. One was mine, though.
You know, Joe.
Yeah, buddy.
When I go for comedic masterminds.
Yep.
I don't go to you.
No, you shouldn't.
I go to Alex Dreyfus.
Yes.
They don't get funnier than that.
Mm-mm.
Here's a little pun from Alex. About 5 minutes after we've talked about McDonald's.
Okay.
McDonald's is like poker. Let's start thinking about it. You're very... Oh, damn. You're very excited once you get there. Once you're finished, you say never again. And then you're back at that Planet Hollywood 80 plus 20 tournament.
That's not a bad metaphor at all.
It's pretty good.
Good job,
pretty
Alex.
Good. I'm sure he didn't come up with it. Sorry, Alex.
Well, it's like that Mitch Hedberg line where he says that, you know, comedy, you got to start strong, you got to end strong. You can't be like pancakes, all exciting in the beginning, and at the end, you're sick of them.
Yeah. J. Joe, Alex Dreyfus will be appearing at the Laugh Factory on Saturday. All poker jokes.
Check the nine. Yep. What did you do?
He did check the nine. Igor's jack is good.
I've received a response from Alex. And this is a very inside joke, Joe, as
well, maybe it's people not don't know. Then.
Well, he just said, make sure to go not to go through my back door.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah.
You expect me to walk around because you have a meeting?
Yeah. Also, he says he needs to see me after the show, so I can't wait for this to be my last show, Joe. At least I'll be not as warm.
Queen high good. She so good.
This guy, Fearmonger, says Mitch Hedberg is the man. Rest in peace.
Yeah, he passed away a few years ago.
What?
Are you
Mitch
putting
Hedberg's
me on?
Mitch dead?
You are putting me on. I've now spent the last several minutes researching Charlotte McKinney. Now I need a nap and a sandwich. You're welcome. Both players with them, they both hit here. This is kind of a scary, scary situation. I mean, scary.
Raise call. Check. Check to you.
Does he have a five?
Does not. Well, technically, he's got a pair of fives.
Two, five. Yeah, that doesn't. I hate that. Don't do that.
Does he have a five?
Don't do that. Don't say that he's got two pair right now. Just don't do it.
GPL online commentator Sam Grafton, that was his line.
He likes doing
made
it.
Made me laugh every time.
Was he doing it ironically? Like,
I'm not sure. But it did make Griffin, it did get Griffin upset from time to time. But
like, everyone's got that pair. It doesn't count.
Like, he has two pair. Like, no, he doesn't.
No, no. He's got all pair.
But that was my
the board's got a pair.
That did make me laugh a lot. Phyllis Diller jokes.
Wait, did something bad happen to Phyllis Diller?
She passed away. I mean, it might not have been bad.
Damn you, 2016!
Yep. I think it was way before 2016.
Back in the game. Something right.
Happy with the Gene Rayburn. Love it. Joe, I have not, still not watched the Sunday nights on ABC with the Pyramid match game. All my favorite shows are back. I saw that the Pyramid is hosted by Michael Strahan, and I think that he is the most overrated person on earth. He's so not good.
He doesn't really do it for me either.
And I'm a football fan. I guess I'm sort of a football fan. Not a Giants fan, obviously, but I think he's good on Fox NFL Sunday, which I assume he's done. But he's pretty bad at what he does.
That pot. No, you win.
Nice. Igor makes the hero call. So that one goes, let's see, two for five now. Not that that was, just a thin call. You know, it wasn't a massive bet, but pretty thin call in the end. Igor with aces.
DeAndre Akaris.
Aces.
Andre Crowley did give me a high five yesterday at the Rio. That's how I got the Rio flu.
I'm so sick of your brags, man. I'm so sick of these. Like, guess who high fived me today?
Faraz Jaka.
Nah.
Mm-mm. Antonio Esfandiari. Nope. Who else did I speak? Robbie Straczynski. No. Alexandre Dreyfus.
Okay.
I saw him.
We can stop now.
Okay. You're good? Is this still on? Okay. Joe, by the way, this is the 46th hand, the longest match game of the match, and you predicted the shortest
I took the
one
under.
To be now. Yeah. Looks like McDonald's hash browns are on you. Vegans can still eat that.
All in.
No.
Good card.
Looks like Igor is going to win this pot.
No, no, no. You still have chips.
Bryn, you still have chips on the table. Bryn, we're going to count those. Yep, still chips.
Igor doubles up. Blinds are 6 and 1200. Can Bryn battle back from 11 big blinds? Find out now on the Global Poker League Summer Series.
Jean-Paul, this is weird. I don't know if Jean-Paul was at the Rio and spying on me, but I did, of course, high-five Alan Kessler. To which he told me I owe him $5, probably.
I like when people say Kessler.
Oh, yeah.
But I do say Kessler.
I win.
You win.
Do you know what I love about Alan Kessler? Is that he said some pretty miserable stuff about the GPI. You know, I work hard on the GPI and the rankings and all that stuff. Still like him. Cannot not like him.
I don't know that he's ever acknowledged me.
What are you talking about?
Like, I see him all the time, like, hey, Alan, and he just puts his head down and runs by. Bryn's all Uh-oh. In with top pair. Four. He's in a good spot to double up.
Four.
Igor's got some outs. Ace, king, four.
Four.
King on the
king,
river.
Just like four.
That is it. Bryn Kenney, you are oot. You are the weakest link. Goodbye.
They always do this
it's
to me.
A beautiful day in the neighborhood, a beautiful day. Remember how Mr. Rogers used to get dressed at the beginning of every show and change his shoes and stuff? We
could
do that for you. That's it. Match over. London Royals wins 2-1.
It's a fun one, right? That was a really fun one. 109 points for those Royals. Look at he. 1 point back.
I thought you could only
place.
Score 9 points in a day.
Yeah. They scored 109. Do you know
That's
why?
That's crazy.
Because Liv told us to give her 109 points.
And Liv Boree?
Boree. Okay. Say it correctly. Olivia Boree.
So what? They started today with 103 points, pick up 6 points today. Now they're at 109.
109.
That moves
Doing
them
fine.
Out of the whole second, third place
That's
tie,
right. yeah,
tie job.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. A little, you know, getting a little separation from those Hong Kong stars who have yet to play this heat so they could actually go back to second. It gets really complicated. But for the moment, the Royals are 1 point back of first place Moscow. So life is good for Igor Kurganov.
So how bad do things look for the New York Rounders right now?
It's all right. 6 points ahead of a playoff spot is all right because it puts a lot of pressure on San Francisco and Heat 6 to do at least 3 points better. So they're all right. It does look...
Ooh, that's a good point. So who's only got one Heat left to play now, right?
New York and San Fran.
London, San Fran, and whoever... And the Berlin.
And the Berlin Bears.
So they're all done. They have just, all those teams have one more shot to get points during the summer series.
Yeah, and San Fran, who played the first game of Heat 5, played the last game of Heat 6, so they don't play until the very last. So at least they'll know what their destiny is at that point. Are you the one that hates me referencing destiny? Someone said that they hated that. I thought it was you because
not me.
You're so negative with
me. I am your density.
Destiny. Ah, very well.
You got a little George McFly thing.
Yeah.
Going.
Yeah.
What do you think Laura is going to ask Igor and Bryn?
She'll probably ask if it was hot. She tends to do that a lot. Are you happy? Mm-hmm. You won. Are you sad you lost? And where is the best day club we should go to, Bryn?
I really hope that is one of the questions because it's too late. I already booked my tickets for rehab for over the weekend.
Oh.
The cool thing is that rehab, it's not cool anymore.
It's true.
Yeah.
It was the original.
Yeah. And so the prices are just way cheap. Like I got a table for the first
That's
time in my
why,
life.
You know, my mom, who's a lifelong banker, she's a president of a bank, would appreciate that story.
Yeah.
Smart move,
sir. Just went for the cheap stuff.
Also means probably just guys. That's how you should know.
Yeah, that's true. Unfortunately, there's just guys on the floor with Laura.
Thanks, guys. Are you happy?
Yeah, it's good. 6 points. I'm definitely happy. It's over expectation.
Was it hot?
Very hot.
And where's the best day club?
Depends where the best DJ is, right?
Yeah, that's true.
We need to know.
Well, today, I'm not sure.
Where are you going today?
Who knows?
Oh, we want to know what's happening on BK's world.
Yeah, I can't get into that information. It's classified.
Jeez, do you know what's happening in BK's world?
I think even BK doesn't know. But right. He has definitely some great options, I'm sure. Too many good opportunities. Yeah.
Exactly. You got to always just keep yourself open, and whatever the best option you have, you take that one.
Okay. Yeah. It's like a game of poker almost.
Exactly.
Yeah. I like this.
We like options.
London Royals winning the match. Liv's going to be a happy bunny today.
Yeah, 6 points is good, definitely.
Still get punishment if you win as well?
I hope so. I mean, we get... It worked, like I just kept calling. No, I still lost a bit more, I think, with calls.
But doing well, 1 point behind the Moscow Wolverines now.
One game as well, right? I think one game, they probably have one more game to play. It's all right though, we'll get them with time.
Yeah, you have time. New York Rounders, better do better next time, huh?
Yep.
And that's it?
Yep.
He's going to the day club. BK's well, yep. Back to you guys.
Mike, look at
Eric, ask me some questions. I'm going to answer them at BK's world style.
How many spots do you have available at your cabana on Saturday?
Yep.
Is it true that you've invited a lot of hot chicks?
Yep.
Are you going to tell us, did you get a room or just a cabana?
Yep. A long story short, we got some friends coming in from LA this weekend. We did get a day bed. We got a day bed, not a cabana.
Whoa. Is that like one bed for all?
Yeah.
Well, that sounds like my Montreal story. First time I went to a strip club. Okay.
Except this is outdoors and, it's probably going to cost me just as much money.
True.
And we'll probably have the exact same amount of sex.
I was going to say.
Zero.
Zero.
All right, let's take a look at some of the league standings before we close things out from today's show.
Here they are, the Montreal Nationals still in first place. I just like saying that. My boys from back home doing really well. And boys and girls, look at me being stupid. Speaking of my boys and girls, best of luck to Kristen Bicknell, second in the $1,500 bounty. She is my girl. She is the WSOP ladies champ from a few years ago. An amazing supernova elite player. No one knows who she is at that table, and that's why she's got a major advantage. One of the biggest killers in Canadian poker. So go on, Chrissy B. But let's talk about those New York Rounders who have gotten a little breathing room. But still, the work isn't done. They will want to finish the summer series somewhere inside that top four.
Okay, do we have another conference to look at?
I prefer my Asia, but...
I prefer your Asia.
The Eurasia Conference, the Wolverines managed to stick in first place, 110 points, but only 1 point back are the London Royals. Liv Bory will be very happy with that. And as Igor mentioned, she will still hand out punishment. Although Kyle Icon did say that there'll be no sleeping on the couch for Igor tonight. So congratulations on that. The Hong Kong Stars do get the opportunity to move up to first place, their own opportunity, later this week. And we'll have to see what happens with the Paris Aviators, who are in the queue on Thursday. The all-French matchup, Paris versus Montreal, which will probably feature non-French-speaking players, so that'll be fun to see. And oh my God, it's him.
I'm here. I'm still here.
Joe's texting you Saturday.
Just working
Saturday
on some of those daybed plans. So that's it, right? We're good? We're good here on the show today?
Maybe we can have a little look at what's happening
tomorrow. Yeah, all right, let's do it.
Because look at these faces.
Where did you guys get that picture of Jake Cody? I mean...
Yeah, that's a 1999 Jake Cody.
That's like his high school graduation photo. Yeah, what is happening over there?
That is very much Triple Crown winner Jake Cody.
And he, of course,
won that heads-up bracelet here at the World Series of Poker, or here in Las Vegas at the World Series of Poker. So a heads-up specialist, of course. Triple Crown winner, as I mentioned. But he's facing the man who was drafted first overall in the GPL, the Rome Emperor, Mustafa Kinnit.
Bro.
These two teams are in last place in their own conferences. There's a lot at stake here. A lot.
It's like
a
Hall of Shame match, right?
It is.
Like whoever wins, we lose.
It's a pretty spectacular Hall of Shame match, though, right?
Yeah, as far as the individual players are concerned, for sure. It'd be great. It's going to be fantastic seeing those guys in the cube. Have not seen either of them yet. I haven't seen either of them playing the GPL. Pretty excited. I haven't seen either one of them all summer.
That's right. That's true. Yeah. Mustafa just making his way to Las Vegas, I believe, this week. And Jake's been around, but busy playing the World Series of Poker and probably a couple of bars.
Probably. Who knows? He's a dad now, so he does things a little more daddy-like. That's it. That's all the time we've got for today's show. I would recommend tuning in tomorrow, though, because Mustafa Kanat is a funny, funny dude. He's a fun guy to watch when there's millions on the line. He should be even more fun in the cube. I'm very much looking forward to tomorrow's show. That is at 11 a.m. local time here in Las Vegas from the Tropicana Park and Ride.
think it's called the Tropicana Thunderdome now.
The Tropicana Thunderdome park and ride and or bus terminal is where we are broadcasting from. Like I said, same time tomorrow. Thanks very much to today's players, Bryn Kenney and Igor Kurganov. We appreciate it. For Laura Cornelius and Eric Danis, I am Joe Stapleton. Smell you later.
Can't get enough of the GPL? Head over to globalpokerleague.com for the most complete and up-to-date standings, schedule, stats, and information on your favorite team, as well as full-length match replays, highlights, and epic hands from all of our matches, and much, much more.
Slow.